5 Elements Robotics. So I'll start with our newest platform. It's a 5E Connect platform. This is a fully autonomous platform built on the robotic operating system. So we have a full suite of robotic behaviors, path planning, localization, navigation, basically the capabilities to move anything from point A to point B. A differentiator with this product is that we have onboard, all the intelligence is on board, and it eliminates the need for additional infrastructure. So commonly robotics environments would need something like beaconing or indoor GPS or magnetic strips or RFID in the floor to help it navigate and localize. We've baked all of that into the base platform itself, so each platform can operate independently, though we'd like to be able to network them together to meet customers' applications. So within the platform, we provide power, data, and mechanical interfaces, so we can customize solutions in the payload to meet a wide variety of applications. So what we're showcasing over to my right there, I'm happy to show it off a little bit later, is the Dash robotic shopping cart. So this is a concept that we've been working with a couple of early customers to develop, and it's kind of that first, we're taking our autonomous platform and building a solution that the customer can use. So we've been partnering with the retailers to develop a shopping cart that could help navigate customers through the store. The idea is they could download a shopping list or build one from our database of products. It would help them to find everything they're looking for. We're integrating security features in and integrating with their existing shopping apps and point-of-sale systems. And overall, the goal is to provide a value added for the retailer that's improving customer experience, hopefully building a bigger basket size. So we're demonstrating that value added for the retailer. And as I was discussing with the Connect platform, we can address a wide variety of applications and markets. So the retailer, big box stores, shopping malls is kind of one end of that. But we've also had early discussions with hotels and hospitality space, airports and airlines, distribution centers, and warehousing. Again, anything that we're looking to move from point A to point B, we believe we can develop a solution for. And just a little bit of where we are is in terms of the status of the project. The prototype that we're showing there, we finished assembly of the first units in December, and we have some early customers that were working on pilot programs in their tech development centers over the course of the year, and we're starting to address some of those softer human interface problems. So how are people going to use it? How are people going to interact with it? And what does the ultimate user-facing application end of it look like? We believe we made a lot of progress with the robotic end of things, so kind of the hard problems, but the soft problems of how do you integrate a product like this into somebody's everyday life in a retail environment, which is has a lot of challenges with a lot of pedestrians, a lot of moving pieces to it, how we can use it, and then ultimately for our customers, how we can demonstrate value added, make things more efficiently for them, and provide a product that ultimately hits their bottom line correctly. That's all I have for today, but happy to take some questions a little bit later. Thank you.